Hello and welcome to another episode of the Steam Free to Play. We're back in our Stormcrow because we don't have any other mechs right now. We're saving up money to get the next Stormcrow, which I believe is going to be a Stormcrow D variant, because I want some variety to the playstyle. So far, everything's just been laser mech, because we've only had this single Stormcrow. But if we get the D variant, we can do three different builds with it. We can do short-range missiles, the Splat, or we can do short-range streaks, the Streakcrow, or we can do long-range missiles, all from that once. We can change things up again, and it won't just be laser every single game, because I assume after a while this probably can get a little bit boring if there's no variety. But we're here, assault on the Force Colony. We're heading to regroup at our base, which is something I wish they did. Is they just drop us all together anyway, because we're gonna regroup anyway. You might as well just put us all together. But that's a whole nother topic that I could talk about. And why don't I do that? Is I would love to see it so that I've seen this mentioned in the MechWarrior forums. Is that instead of dropping a spread out, like one team here, and one team here, and one team here, and the opponents are spread out as well, here, here, and here, I'd rather it be like, have, say, five or six different drop points around the map. So say, here, one, two, three, four, and five, and all your 12 mechs are dropped at one of those points, and all the opponent's 12 mechs are dropped at one of the other points. But you don't know which one. So that way you would actually have to scout. You'd actually have to go and find your opponents, because you wouldn't know if they were to your left or to your right or across the entire map, and people could move around and acquired. There would be areas of the maps that
new target acquired.
You would use that normally you wouldn't. Like, in this, on this map, pretty much all the fighting is going to happen in this area between the two bases. And that's just because that's what occurs. But if people were dropped randomly around the map, new target acquired. Then there could be some possibility for incoming different missile. Areas of the map to be used. And incoming missiles, just dodge those, allow them to hit the tree. And we'll move forward here on the right.
New target acquired.
Now, I can't see that person, but I saw that the little triangle was hollow, and that meant I had a line of sight on them. So I was able to lock up on them and shoot through this bush here in order to get some damage in. Moving forward here on the right, we're going to scrape around this corner. Oh, let the timber scrape first.
Warning. Incoming missile.
Somebody's shooting missiles at me for some reason, but thankfully rocks are overpowered and they will absorb all the missiles for me. There's an opponent. Acquired. Put a shot into his arm and back into cover.
New target acquired.
Just work in the corner. They seem to have a fair amount of those missile launchers back there. Let's look in the sky. Don't see any UAVs. It's not like we're getting disproportionately rained on. Let me cross here. Remember to go behind the enemies. Well, not behind the enemies, behind your allies that are on the firing line, as to not get in their way. We'll pop up here and put a really good standing shot into that Raven. He stood still, I stood still, and I drained all of my firepower into his face, coring him out, which is excellent. That is exactly what I wanted to happen. And he's getting away, that's fine. I'll just poke out here a little bit. Try to find an enemy. we saw a target pop up here. I'm just going to move around to this side, get into cover, try to break line of sight. Let's see if we can push the water side. There was a target pop-up I saw over here just very shortly. Yeah, there he is. Acquired. Stormcrow in the water. Holder locks on him. There's a locust there.
New target acquired.
That guy will take a lot of damage against one of our shots. Oh, it's too much to go around that corner to shoot him. He's in cover now. I would be exposing myself to all those enemies over there. That's just something I don't want to do.
New target acquired.
They're just surrounding you guys.
New target acquired.
We're doing okay. I'm holding them off on the left side here. And I'm definitely going to win the trade with this Stormcrow and a single medium laser. So I can hold this corner.
New target acquired.
What is that? Blackjack. Is it 20 on that blackjack? That is not a threat at this range. But now that he's moving closer, I'm going to start to back up and take another position. Because he's going to come around this corner, and I don't want him to be in his effective range. And I also want to be able to sort of use this tree as cover if I need to. There. Be able to dodge his shots there. And he's moving back because he's not in his effective. He's not able to pressure that corner because I repositioned.
New target acquired.
We have an opponent there way out on the left. All of our allies are going out here. We have to commit with them.
New target
Step
acquired.
Out. Whoop. Try to shoot, but opponent
New target
allies
acquired.
Are getting in the way. Shot at the blackjack.
New target acquired. New target
let
acquired.
Us move out.
New
I'm trying
target
to stay
acquired.
A little bit closer to the water line here. One to stay out of view of the opponents.
New target
and
acquired.
Also be a little bit closer for my weapons because of the effective range. Okay, I want to get a little bit close here. This is a little bit dangerous what I'm doing, but I feel like this position here is quite strong.
New target
good
acquired.
Hit into that blackjack. I gotta assume I got missiles locked onto me. Nope. Okay. Another really good hit into him. His CT is almost down. Nope. Gotta fall back. Incoming missiles. Change direction. Dodged. Excellent.
New target acquired.
Pick up a kill. Got the kill most damage dealt on that. Not sure who that was. There's a Jaeger mech down there that we get to put some damage into.
Enemy base is being captured.
That I don't think he knows that we're up here.
Heat level critical.
Oof, excellent. We've done a lot of damage acquired. To him.
Enemy base
ooh,
is
that
captured.
Locust is really low.
Heat level critical. Target destroyed.
And he's down.
Heat
excellent. Excellent. We got our first Phoenix mech kill.
Heat level critical.
So go for that other tied torso on the Dire. Just gonna use my arm weapons again. Excellent, he's down. Drop and continue to push the allies that are distracting and getting the enemies to come back to the base. I need to maximize on that. Oh, he's Lurms! Okay, push him, push him, push him. I didn't expect a Lurm King Crab, because Lurm King Crabs are bad. But Within is effective now. He can't use those Lurms against us. And we easily took off all of his firepower. Just using my large pulse to stay heat efficient. He's down. Blackjack. Okay, I kind of smeared my shot there. But this should be a nice... There we go. Good shot there.
Base 25% captured.
I'll head back to base. Everybody else, push.
Base is being captured.
Oof, we gotta get the people off base.
Base 50% captured.
You can't stop this push. Gotta just go for base.
Critical damage. Base is being captured. Center torso. Damage. Light lamp destroyed. Right torso. Critical damage. Left arm. Critical damage. Base 75% captured. Enemy base is being captured. Base is being captured.
Oh my god, there's one last guy on base. Oh, legs.
Destroyed.
Yes! Oh my god, that was close. Ooh. It was the choice to go back to base. And we made a ton of money, and unfortunately I wasn't able to play a bunch and my premium time has run out. But we did it! We got our first 1,000 damage game! Woo! 5 kills, 6 assists. That is excellent. You may notice now I have a faction and a unit tag, and that is from faction from a guy I know from the last free-to-play series I did, and I'll probably be joining them for some community warfare eventually when we get to that stage and have the mechs to do it. But for now, on to the next match.
Sensors online.
For the second episode, second match, god, gotta keep my things straight. We are on Frozen City. My brain's not working very well today. I did kind of just get up, start playing games. It's kind of interesting. It takes so bloody long to process some of these things. Like, I'll play this thing. I'll play these matches. It'll take me 30, 40 minutes to do this. To do the recording. Then I'll go and put it into Sony Vegas and edit it. That only takes me like 10 minutes. And then I'll render it. But that takes like 2 hours. Oop, there's opponents. Nice little shot there. Not going to pop out again in that position and into cover. And then, so that's going to take a couple hours to render. And then it's going to take like a billion and a half years to upload because my internet's absolutely horrible, at least in terms of upload speed. So it's kind of funny, for every like, I don't know, hour of video I make, it takes me like another 6 to process it afterwards. It definitely takes away from the time there. Alright, that was a really good trade. Looks like all their attention is on our guys. Push, 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 push! Make the call to push there, and let's have a fun match. Through, go for this Atlas. Try to wheel in behind him here. Excellent, he's got taken out. Oof. Scary damage. So much missiles. We'll go for that guy's leg if he ever comes back. Good hit on that Jenner. We are running hot now. Just gonna use my large pulse for a second. Until things cool down. Okay, now I'm cool again. I can start using all my weapons. Ooh, I lost my right side. That's unfortunate. Alright, just keep attacking. Best we can do, drop that guy. Still fairly equal. It kind of sucks I'm having to scrape my right side with only left-sided weapons, so I gotta reset and go to a different position here.
Base is being captured. New target acquired.
Try to work on this awesome in the background there. Acquired. Maybe that adder. Yeah, I can't stay out there. That adder will eat me.
Base is being captured. New target acquired.
Trying to push around this side. Ah, not working. I get taken out. Yeah. Just next time, when they're gonna do a distraction, call it out. That way people know what you're doing, and we'll be able to assist you with it. But hey, it was a good fight anyway. We could probably take that guy out. Oh, there you go, the guy's down. Excellent. It's 6-6. It is equal so far. They're, opponent that was on our base is not there anymore. He's come back to defend. Ooh. A catapult is now down to half firepower. This Evon Jaguar could do a fair amount of damage. Clean up this match. Let's see what else our allies have. Enforcer with AC-10. Oh, but it's in your right arm, so it went into the building. But now it's gonna appear. There you go. Oh, there we go. The Atlas is down. It's 9-6. Oh, we're going to win. Woohoo! That push made us win. Excellent.
Target acquired. Heat level critical. Left arm critical.
Very nice. And that catapult is stripped. He's not really a threat anymore.
Target
so
destroyed.
Really should be focusing on him. And the last opponent, I believe, is the PPC Adder. Good work, team.
Target acquired. Target destroyed.
And GG to our opponents. Woo! So that was a nice push. That was a fun battle. Don't mind that I died. I had fun while I was fighting. Let's see what we did. Nice. Another 113,000 C-bills. 458 damage. On to the next game.
Reactor online.
And the last sensors match of this video.
Weapons online.
Crimson Strait. Conquest, I believe.
All systems.
Yes. So let's move forward and conquest those points. So there has been some progress for the Christmas video or holiday video or whatever I'm going to call it. Yeah, I might be getting some stuff to give away for that event to celebrate the 1,000 subscribers and also just for sort of a little holiday thing. So, I will know more in the next couple days, but most likely it will be a holiday video coming out on Christmas Day. Then I'll have some kind of thing in the video that people have to like leave a comment or do something to enter. And then I will select the winner within a couple days after that. Not exactly sure yet, but we should figure it out. All right, we got Kappa there. I'm just gonna take a peek over the saddle here and see if they're pushing that. Normally that team doesn't on Conquest because they want to get to Theta area and they want to secure that, but it's just always a good thing to check. Nothing over the saddle. All right. Let's move towards Theta, which it looks like we have a fair amount of opponents there. Well, we have a fair amount of people that went onto the island. That's really interesting. I honestly haven't seen that strategy in practically forever. Peek through there, nothing. Try to peek this way, get some shots in.
New target acquired.
Trying to use this tower here as partial cover as to not be completely open, but that Marauder there just took a bunch of damage inside from me. Alright, looks like I'm getting awesome damage in here. Got another guy, is he gonna come up? Not sure.
New target acquired. New target acquired.
Push forward a little bit. Get some hits on that adder. I feel like I haven't been spotted yet, which is nice. Probably have been. But I've been doing fairly well in this position here. I definitely got spotted there. Yep, incoming missile. Move back. Ooh, enemies got Kappa. They're up here.
Acquired.
This is no good. This is no good. We're going to die up here. Dive, 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 dive. Whatever's down here is better than up there. Maybe not, but I don't know. It should be. Wow, okay. That was intense. We do have some opponents at Kappa that could push us down. We kind of need to push into them and start taking some of these points because we're going to run out of caps really quickly here. I'm going to take this Direwolf out. CT super low. Got him. Okay.
New target acquired.
Now they're dropping down in behind us. So try to help with that. I'm going to go for this guy's leg. The legs sometimes are too... people take armor off them too much. And you can take them out quite easily. So now that guy's screwed in terms of mobility. And we can rip him apart. But we are losing on caps greatly. We definitely need to focus on getting some of them.
New target acquired.
So I'm going to step into this cap circle and start taking Theta as I put fire into this King Crab. Oop, a little bit of a rendering glitch there.
New target acquired.
How are we doing? We're winning the fight greatly, but now we need to get these caps. So Theta is neutralized. I'm going to go straight for Kappa. The thing is, when you get these caps, you kind of don't need to capture them back. You just need to neutralize them and move on. There's an opponent. Oh, I slipped. That wasn't good. Let's get back up there.
Target destroyed.
What? Looks like we got one opponent left? Two opponents, and I think they're up here near Kappa. At least I believe. Got some enemy missiles flying. There's one of them. Is there another up here? I'm just going to get into Kappa to start to uncap it. and flip over and shoot this direction. Take off some components. Excellent. So there's that guy, and then one more. I don't know where he is, but uncapping this will help secure the win for us. The last one is Gamma. This Raven is here. And let's just head for Gamma. Just uncap it and secure the game. But really, at this point, we are basically secure. Oh, B2. Out near Epsilon? Yeah, Epsilon. At this point, we're basically secured. If we have 4 and they have 1, pretty much no matter the point difference, we will win eventually. Because the point gain is just so low. But the last opponent is on Epsilon, and we're going to push out towards that direction. Let's see here. If I had an artillery strike, I would drop it on that point, but I do not. And let's see, if he pushes out to the left here past us. Although if I was him, I would go like this way, cut back in, which is probably what he is doing. But at least if he did come this way, we'd have been able to cut him off. He's turning back, he's heading back this way. Let's head back through B3. Let's head this way. I'm predicting that he's here, and he's heading this way right now. So instead of going and following around, I'm cutting him off, at least trying to. Yeah, there he is.
A4B4.
Yeah, we're probably gonna run into him. Yep. Got him. He's mine. Haha. And that is the predictive power of being, I think it's gonna go this way. And that is how I get some of those kills. But good game to our opponents. And good game to end off the video. Oh, another great high damage game, 273,000 C-bells, and we got 879 damage, 3 kills, 8 assists, top of the team, excellent. And connecting back up here and getting my cadet bonus, we're going to see how many C-bells we have and see how far we are from our Stormcrow. Connect, connect, connect. It always seems to take a little while to do this. And there we go. So we are at 9.7 million. And we go into the battle mechs and go medium. Stormcrow. The Delta is the next one for all those missile hardpoints. So wonderful. And that will be 11.1 million. So not that far away, but we are reaching the end of our cadet bonus, which we will definitely reach the end of by the end of next video, because we only have 2 more matches left. So this will only give us a little bit more bonus, and then we're down to just our normal match rewards. So we'll go through the end of the cadet bonus next episode, but for now, thank you for watching this episode of the Steam Free to Play. Good hunting.